Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. And I want to see you. High and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy, holy. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. And I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up, shining.
This is Soul Cafe Radio, food for the mind and soul.
A pleasant good morning to each and every one of you listening at this time, and just want to say also to those who will be listening later on, thank you for tuning in to Soul Cafe Radio from the heart. This week, which is recorded February 8th to the 12th, we'll be looking at a very important topic here as we continue our series, February, as we look at faith to move mountains. This week, we're looking at the Christian race. Today's topic is the case for endurance, the case for endurance. And as usual, we'll be reading from the book, From the Heart, on today's date, February 8th. The topic is, of course, the Christian race. And also, later on in our study, we'll be coming from 1 Corinthians 9, 24 to 27. So if you have the devotional book handy, we'll be reading from there, and 1 Corinthians 9, 24 to 27 will be our theme of study. But, of course, as usual, before we do anything else, here on Soul Cafe Radio, and, of course, in everything that we ought to be doing, we need to invite the Lord's blessings to join us, to be with us, to let His words and His thoughts, His ideas be expressed and never ours. Pray with me. Heavenly Father, I want to thank you so much for your loving kindness towards us. Thank you for those who are listening at this time and those who will be listening to the podcast version. I pray, O God, that your Holy Spirit will just drive every person who listens to their knees. Father, I pray that today's message will be such a message that it will leave a deep and lasting impact on those who hear. Bless your words to your hearts, we pray, even now, in Jesus' name. Amen. So again, friends, you are tuned to Soul Cafe Radio from the Heart. I'm your host, the Wordmaster. And today and this week, we'll be looking at a very important topic as we continue our series, Fab, URI, looking at faith, faith to move mountains. Our scripture reading is taken from 1 Corinthians 9, as we said, 24 to 27. And the Bible says, "Know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receives the prize. So run that ye may obtain. And every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a corruptible crown, but we an incorruptible. I therefore so run, not as uncertainly, so fight I, not as one that beateth the ear." Here's the kicker, verse 27. "But I keep under my body and bring it into subjection, lest that by any means, when I have preached to others, I myself should be a castaway." And that right there is the focus of our study. But we turn now to our morning devotional session, which comes to us, as always, from the heart, February 8th. The scripture reading comes from Hebrews chapter 12 and verse 1. It says, "Let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily ensnares us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us." Hebrews 12 and verse 1. In this text, on the public game so famous in Paul's time, is used to illustrate the race submitted to a painful training process, practicing the most rigid denial and their physical powers, that your physical powers might be in the most favorable condition. And then they tax these powers. And then they tax these powers to the utmost to win the honor of a perishable wreath. Some never recovered from the effects. In consequence of the terrible strain, men would sometimes fall by the race course, bleeding at the mouth and nose. Others breathed out their last, firmly grasping the poor bauble that had cost them so dear. Paul compares the followers of Christ to the competitors in a race. Now says the apostle, "They do it to obtain a corruptible crown, but we an incorruptible." Here Paul makes a sharp contrast to put to shame the feeble efforts of professed Christians who plead for their selfish indulgences and refuse to place themselves by self-denial and strict temperance in a position that they will make a success of overcoming. All who entered the list in the public games were animated and excited by the hope of a prize if they were successful. In like manner, a prize is held out before Christians, the reward of faithfulness to the end of the race. If the prize is won, their future welfare is assured. An exceeding and eternal weight of glory is in reserve for the overcomers. In the races, the crown of honor was placed in sight of the competitors, that if any were tempted for a moment to relax their efforts, the eye would rest on the prize, and they would be inspired by new vigor. So the heavenly goal is presented to the view of the Christian, that it may have its just influence and inspire all with zeal and ardor. All ran in the race, but only one received the prize. It is not so with the Christian race. None who are earnest and persevering will fail of success. The race is not to the swift, nor the battle to the strong. The weakest saint as well as the strongest may obtain the crown of immortal glory if they are thoroughly in earnest and will submit to privation and loss for Christ's sake. This is from the heart, February 8th, and that was a powerful reading that will transition us into our lesson for the morning. And indeed, it was a great first leg of the baton that would take us through up until Friday morning. After we come back from our commercial break and our song, we'll be looking at most important thought, the Christian race, the case for endurance. Stay tuned.
Oh, to Jesus I surrender, all to him I freely give. I will ever love and trust him in his presence day.
Have you ever done anything that was, well, put it this way, you started off strong, but in the end, you came across a loser. You came across defeated because you was not able to endure. Have you ever been in a position where you looked at a situation and you said, yes, I could tackle that, I could handle it, but then ultimately you failed because you was not able to finish? This is what we'll be looking at today on Soul Cafe Radio from the Heart in our special February edition. Turn back to 1 Corinthians 9, 24 to 27. The Bible says, "Know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receiveth the prize? so run that you may obtain. Our topic again is the Christian race, the case for endurance. Many people in their training become so self-assured, so self-centered, so cocky that they don't adhere to the strict regimen that they've been given. They think that because they've trained for X amount of weeks, months, years, that they're now ready and qualified to go in a race and just from the get-go, give it all they got. But that's not how it works, friends. You see, even though many, many competitors enter the natural race, chances are all of them will not make it to the end. As such as it was in the ancient games, so it is today. Competition is very fierce, but every competitor is not at the same level, obviously. But what makes this doubly disappointing is that you've trained with a person for X amount of time, and you constantly drill in their heads, listen, this race is not a sprint, it's a marathon, and you are going to have to, you're going to have to reserve your strength for the later laps. Don't be too quick, don't be too eager to be out front first. You can lag behind for a little bit, it does not matter. Reserve your strength for the finish. And you can drill that into their heads all season, all throughout training. But on race day, and they see the lights and the glitter and the glamour, the cameras, the spectators, the roar of the crowd, and something ultimately within them triggers some kind of mechanism kicks in, and all of a sudden, all that good training goes out the window. Why? Because of pride, of course. And so, just like the here in the parable of the tortoise and the hare, they sprint to a fast start. They give it all. They leave nothing in that early stage. And by the end of the race, true to words, they're burnt out. That is a fit emblem, a fit analogy, a fit parable of what happens in many Christian experiences. They start off strong. They endure for a little bit. Their lights burn bright for a while. But ultimately, friend, ultimately, with that strategy, you have to burn out. Now, friends, one of the most beautiful things in a Christian experience is that he or she does begin in their Christian walk burning brightly. Burning brightly. Their glow is out of this world. You can tell that they have a relationship with Jesus. But you see, friends, that relationship has not been allowed to foster, to grow. It has been usurped. It has been replaced by something else. And so therefore, early burnout takes the place of that glow and that ear stage that is supposed to be reached is never reached. It stayed at the blade level, much less to say the full corn in the ear. The case for endurance, dear listener, is critical. Let me repeat. The case for endurance is critical. We may start off strong. Yes, we can. But if we pace ourselves, we'll make it through. If we do not get overwhelmed by external stimuli, we will make it through. The problem is that the majority of the runners are so caught up that they're trying to be first right away. It does not work that way. And of course, as we've seen in the Christian journey, it has been a 2,000 plus year experience since we first were privy to those words, "Behold, I come quickly." Friend of mine, let me tell you this. If you're not willing to endure, then you're not willing to receive the prize. Look at what the apostle goes on to say. And every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things. He says, now they, the game runners, do it to obtain a corruptible crown, but we, an incorruptible. Back in his day, the emblem of honor was to receive a wreath of laurel. And to them, that was high honor. To their city, that was high honor. But as the song says, we have no abiding city here. We can't call none of this place home. And so, as you've come to 2021, dear listener, let me just say this. There's nothing that we ought to be fighting for in this world. Literally nothing in this world that we could lay claim to. Nothing. At the songwriter says again, this world is not my home. I'm just a passing through. Sadly, many Christians have indeed laid down their pilgrim label and have taken up the mantle of a settler. They're settled. Oh, it's not going to be for another 100 years or so. No, we have time. And self-delusion kicks in. Friend of mine, that's a terrible condition to be in at this time. Self-delusion, I'm in. Watching a race on TV or at the stadium is one thing. Actually realizing that you're in that race is altogether another thing. So, if you are a spectator of the race, you don't worry about your diet. You don't worry about your sleep patterns. You don't worry about whether you are in the most optimal shape, because it's just your eyes that are going to be getting the workout. You are a spectator after all. But being in the race is something altogether different. And so, being a participant in the race now means that your whole life has got to change. It says, every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things. See, all those things I just mentioned in the natural, in the spiritual, those are manifested as well as things in the natural. And why? Because in the world they do it to obtain a corruptible crown, something that's going to perish. But we, who are believers, and incorruptible. And the Apostle Paul goes on to say, I therefore so run, not as uncertainly, so fight I, not as one that beats the air. And like I said, verse 27 is the kicker and our capstone for today. It says, but I keep under, talking about submitting the body, I keep under my body. Like our song said, I surrender all. But I keep under my body and bring it into subjection, lest by any means, when I have preached to others, I myself should be a castaway. Friend of mine, those are some of the most sobering words in all of Scripture, simply for the fact that it's letting us know that those of us who seek to set the examples have got to endure, have got to maintain. So what? It's 2021. And we are not home yet. So what? You should look at the positive instead of the negatives. You still have time to reach lost souls. You still have time to refine your character even further. You still have time to vindicate the honor and the glory and the character of God. You still have time. Because I'm telling you, friends, soon and very soon, that won't be the case. And you may not believe it now. It may seem strange to say, but you're going to be longing for these days when you had days to save a soul, days to study more, days to learn more. And so in these days that we're living in, it behooves you to do exactly what the apostle says. Bring the body into subjection. Keep it under. Let the mind dominate the flesh and not the other way around. Feed the spirit and don't feed the flesh. In fact, starve the flesh to death. Don't give it anything to feast on. And that will be a good thing as we go forward. We're going to pause here because it is time to transition. But before I leave you, I just want to say this, friends. Please join me all week for the presentations. Tomorrow's presentation is going to go more into detail of what we talked about today in the Christian race. And as you join me all week, we'll get deeper and deeper. But I want to pause to interject a plug for my Spirit Talk with the Word Master podcast coming up here live today at 9 a.m. Eastern Time. And I'll be in studio with Carl, my co-host on the Antidote to Deception podcast, which also is today, later on tonight, that'll be going up. So the information is in the description, and as soon as 9 o'clock hits, it'll be uploaded, it'll be there. And so friends, as I close, let me just remind you that yes, I said it, even though it's 2021 and Christ is not here, so what? It just gives us time to endure. And you know something else, something is happening. You're seeing, on one hand, an awakening. Many of God's children are waking up to the fact that they have not been and doing so right by the Lord. But many, many, many are taking up those beds from which the others came out of just now. And they're going to sleep because, frankly, they've given up the fight. So fight I, the apostle says. So fight I. Friends, that is the last words I want to leave with you. The fight is on. Keep fighting. Don't give up. Don't give in. Soon and very soon, Jesus Christ will come to claim his people as his own. As usual, like I said, on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Friday, I cut the audio portion of our study short, but allow you to continue to hear some very beautiful music. I believe, friends, by the grace of God, that as we continue to grow into Christ, that this subject of endurance will become more and more paramount, because too many Christians, or so-called Christians, are dropping off like flies because Christ Jesus is not being allowed. He's not being allowed to be the center of their lives. And of course, you'll always have problems when that is the case. Heavenly Father, I want to thank you so much for your love and kindness and your tender mercy. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for what you're doing, for what you've done and what you're doing. I pray, dear God, that as we get off the ear, dear Lord, for today, that you may bless the listening audience, that you'll do for them that which only you can. Thank you for hearing our
His precious blood.
Dear God, your good and perfect work in their lives, I pray. Bless them, O Father, to continue to like the odds that stuck against them, dear God.
Fast as the
ocean. That the Christian race, oh God, will continue to be one sport that they are not spectators in, but actually participants. Bless each and every one of us now, dear God, as we continue to go throughout the rest of our days in praise.
Who his love will not remember, who can see. Crucifixion, fountains opened deep and wide. Through the floodgates of God's mercy flowed a vast and gracious tide. Grace and love like mighty rivers poured instead. The guilty world in love, through his love.
deeper, no love is truer, no love is higher, no love is wider, no love is like your love, oh Lord. No love is higher, no love is wider, no love is deeper, no love is truer, no love is higher, no love is wider, no love is like your love, oh Lord. No love is higher, no love is wider, no love is deeper, no love is truer, no love is higher, no love is wider, no love is like your love, oh Lord. Here is love, here is love, here is love. No love is higher, no love. There's the ocean. Here is love, vast as the ocean. This here is love, vast as the ocean.
In the field burst forth with blooming, and the wind seems to whisper, he's alive. Even the trees lift their branches in perfect harmony with the creator of the world. But there's just something about my praise he loves. There's just something about the way I speak his name, Jesus. the Lord has been so real to me. He's given me a special kind of love, and I have more to thank my Father for than all the angels in heaven above. Special to the Father above, and just because I'm his child, there is something about my praise he loves. There's just something about the way I speak his name.
Was paralyzed by fear when they heard a mighty multitude was quickly drawing near. But as they prayed for deliverance, the victory would begin. For when we call upon the Lord, we summon all of heaven. Worshipping the Lord, it seemed there was no hope at all for what would be in store. But when we stand on holy ground, our smallest prayer is heard. Instead of on our circumstance, our eyes are on. Prayers may seem in vain, they don't seem to make a difference. They don't seem to make a change. Just rest assured, God knows your needs, and He hears each time you pray. Your prayers are reaching heaven, and the answer's on the way.
Through these trials, you will win.
You've been listening to Soul Cafe Radio. Join us next time for powerful messages, music, and more. And remember to visit our website at www.soulcafeonline.com.